Seniors, you may sit. Just a little flash flood this morning, no problem. Welcome, families, grandparents, parents, caregivers, faculty, staff, students, alumni, and trustees. We are also glad that you're here. I'd like to take a moment to recognize our faculty and staff, and we have some sitting because they have some students, their children are graduating. But if you were a faculty or staff member, would you please stand? And you'll notice we've flanked the sides. And can we please give our faculty staff a huge round of applause? And before they depart, some are gonna head over to the Bell Family Studio, some are gonna find their seats. I'd like to give a special recognition to one faculty member, Mr. Don Leahy, who's retiring after 25 years at Greensboro Day School. All right, thank you. Okay, here we go. You ready?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Would members of the Board of Trustees stand? We are here because in large part of your support. And I know I've got our chair behind us, but members of the trustees, would you please stand? We want to thank you for all of your support of the school. And good morning, seniors.
Good morning.
Thank you, Xander. Today, we celebrate you, the class of 2022. In our community, you have served thousands of community service hours. 38 of you will continue your education in the great state of North Carolina, while 41 of you will matriculate to 21 states and one country. You are moot court trial attorneys. You are visual artists, athletes, bingo bigs. You are welders, you're mathematicians, you're stage managers, you're musicians, you're philanthropists, your actors, your peer tutors, some of you are entrepreneurs, and athletes and friends. Today, you will officially say goodbye to GDS, and you will receive a plethora of advice from today's speakers, including myself. Your brains have stored lots of knowledge, and you have developed skills and competencies that you have developed since you've been here, and you will apply in college. However, there are three things I hope that you do prioritize as you embark on your next adventure. One of them would be kindness. Let's see if these words might ring familiar to some of you. You're not that kind of bird I call my own. You sure don't look like me. You're not in my tree. How are we gonna live together? We'll find a worm with someone new. Find out you have feathered friends that you never knew. Those are the words from Songbird, the lower school musical that debuted a couple weeks ago. It was a wonderful message, and those words were written and composed by our lower school musical teacher, Jill Hare. So much of the world's divisions stem from people choosing not to be kind to others because they don't look alike, they don't act the same, they don't vote the same, or they don't behave the same. So these words of kindness, I really hope you will model and take with you wherever you go. The second piece of advice would be valuing human connection. Here's a piece from Songbirds. It seems all you birds have wised up to your call to be there to help each other, every bird, one and all. This life can be tough and leave you feeling alone, but supporting each other helps us feel like we're home. Just as I stated this time last year, the pandemic has taught us lots of things, but the one thing I think we've all realized is the value of human connection. So please pay attention to what's right in front of you. Make time to put your devices away and take in your friends and family this summer before you head off to your next adventure. Yes, the metaverse is here, but make sure you're paying attention to the people right in front of you. And then finally, attitude. If you haven't seen the Rollins College graduation and this year's commencement speech delivered by the valedictorian Elizabeth Bonkers, I highly recommend it to everyone. It is on YouTube. She has nonverbal autism, and she delivered one of the most inspiring talks that I've heard in a really long time. She can't speak, but her attitude comes through in the commencement speech, and it's fantastic. In her speech, she quotes Viktor Frankl, who was a Holocaust concentration survivor, and he wrote one of the books that's probably most read in the world. And his name's Viktor Frankl. The book's called Man's Search for Meaning. And here's a great quote about attitude that I think about regularly. Everything can be taken from a man but one thing, the last of human freedoms. To choose one's attitude in any set of circumstances is to choose one's way. So be that positive force. And when you're not up for doing it, lean on someone who can help you do that. Seek out those people in your life who are positive forces. And now, as you begin to put the 21-22 school year behind you and GDS, please remember how proud we will always be of you. Thank you for all that you've done to make us better educators and leaders. And thank you for sharing your feedback, your talents, your kindness, your leadership, and your humor. And please know, whenever you return, we will always be here for you. Once a Bengal?
Always a Bengal.
Okay, great. I know it's early. That's pretty good. And now I'd like to welcome our interim director of upper school, Peter Williams, who will introduce our student speakers.
Good morning, everyone. I have the honor of introducing our two student speakers today. Both of these graduates were elected by their peers to serve on this year's student council, and they've led their fellow students with grace and honor. First, we'll hear from Warren McWhorter, our executive student council president, and he will be followed by Anna Newsom, the senior class president. Warren, please come to the podium.
Thank you, Mr. Williams. It's hard not to start this graduation speech with a funny story from my 13 years here at GDS, but I believe that there's something much more important. On behalf of my peers, I would like to thank all the parents, coaches, teachers, and special friends that made this day a reality. As we move on to a new chapter in our lives, we should always look back and recognize the people who aided us on our journey. This journey through GDS has been an adventure, to say the least. For some of us, the journey began in lower school, where we quickly learned that growing up was harder than it seems. Nap times in kindergarten quickly turned into the infamous Mad Minutes. During our second chapter at GDS, we endured many rainy trips at Mr. Ed's farm, Class 5 Rapids at the White Water Center, and the big city life of DC. And finally, in high school, we attended dances, adapted to online school, and almost completed a full game of Thunder Tag. No matter where your journey began at GDS, you will always have a special event to remember. The class of 2022 is a very special class. We will be remembered as the most adaptive class in GDS history. As early as fifth grade, we were forced into a new environment. We were the first fifth grade class in the middle school. Many of us had mixed emotions about carving a new path on Greensboro Day School's road to graduation, but regardless of those emotions, we set the standard high. Fast forward to this year, we were charged with a new task. As a class of 2022, we needed to help bring back GDS students to normal school life. This year, we were the only upper schoolers to have had a full year of regular high school at GDS before COVID. We were the only grade to attend both fall ball and homecoming. We were the only grade to have a full year without masks in the high school. Underclassmen looked up to us for guidance, and we provided it. We were able to return to a mask optional policy. We had assemblies in the theater, student-led events, the backpacking trip, and even senior projects. None of this would have been possible without our leadership and dedication to Greensboro Day School. Thank you, class of 2022. Looking forward to next year, I have no doubts that we will do great things. We are spreading out to over 20 states, attending 46 different colleges, and pursuing many different interests. A piece of advice that I was given this year during my senior project is to always set yourself up for the future. By enrolling here at GDS, we have set ourselves up for success. No matter what career path we choose in the future, we must always think about how to make ourselves better prepared. Thank you, and congratulations, class of 2022. All right, next up, Anna Newsom, senior class president.
Good morning, everyone. I want to begin by thanking everyone for being here today. We could not have done it without you and all of your support. The past few weeks have been a whirlwind of events. We had our last day ever of high school, worked hard on our senior internships, and hiked through Pisgah National Forest together. As I stand up here today, I'm so thankful to be able to represent this amazing class and all that we have been through and accomplished this year. We are leaving the place that shaped us into young adults and going out to make an impact in the world. As a class, I think we can all agree on one thing. The people that have surrounded us for the past 4 years have brought out the best in us. When I sat down to write this speech, I had no clue what I wanted to say. I felt as if I were trying to speak for the whole class without actually knowing what I wanted to share with everyone. So late Tuesday night, I sent out a Google form asking my classmates to send me things they wanted to pass along to you all here today. First, we want to thank our families. You all have been there for birthday parties, long nights, homework help, and probably have reconsidered having kids a few times. The past 13 years could not have been accomplished without you, and for that, we thank you. My classmates wanted to share these few words. Thank you for showing up every step of the way and being there when we needed you. And your unyielding support will not be taken for granted. An education at GDS is a commitment and an investment into each of our futures, and I hope we prove it was well worth it. We are so thankful for you all, and want you to know all those late nights, homework help, teacher-parent conferences, and unconditional love and support will not be forgotten. It has always seemed to me that teachers are almost like a second set of parents. You all supported us, helped us, taught us lessons, sometimes had to discipline us, but thankfully did not have to deal with us when we were at home. We know you all care about us deeply and would do anything we asked if you believed it would help us succeed. I know this because of the amount of times our class would discuss how we would email Mr. Gregory at 1 a.m. and he would respond at 1:01. Teachers, we want to share these few messages with you. And I quote, thank you for always believing in our capability to succeed and encouraging us to become lifelong leaders. Thank you for enriching our lives and teaching us life lessons that are applicable beyond the classroom. And thank you for all their support. Please give yourself a pat on the back because we were once known as one of the worst grades, but you somehow knocked us into shape and look where we are now. Last but not least, class of 2022, we are finally having to part ways with each other after many years of friendship. We have been through a pandemic, an extremely wet SBT trip, online learning, fantasy football cheating scandals, singing battles outside the Student Life Center, flick meals, and getting to know each other more and more as we keep growing into the people we are today. We will always be connected in some way. And no matter how many new memories we make as we start our new chapters, we will always have the memories that we created together. We will cross paths again one day, and it will always be an honor to be a part of this graduating class and to have known you all. As we walk across the stage today, I want everyone here to know, no matter what role you played in our lives, you are the reason we are the people we are today. And to the class of 2022, you will never be forgotten, because once a mingle, always a mingle. Thank you. And now back to Ms. Catlett.
Thank you, Warren and Anna. How about one more round of applause for our student speakers? The Greensboro Day School's class of 2020 completed their graduation in a non-traditional fashion when the pandemic took hold of our country and stay-at-home orders were in place. In honor of the class of 2020, who did not experience a traditional graduation, the Class of 2020 Resilience Award is presented annually at graduation to remember this senior class, but also honor someone in this year's senior class who best exemplifies resilience.
Please welcome Zaira Arfin, a member of GDS's Class of 2020, who will present this year's 2020 Resilience Award. Come on up, Zaira.
Good morning, graduates, families, faculty, and staff. My name is Zaira Arfin, and today I have the honor of presenting the Class of 2020 Resilience Award to a student who has exhibited true determination. When faced with adversity, this student pushes through with a quiet determination admitted by both his peers and teachers. Throughout his high school career, he has continued to show this level of grit and resilience. His father speaks about his inner strength, and his teammates and classmates attest to it as well. I'm proud to present the Resilience Award today to Jack Phillips.
Jack, we have something for you after the ceremony. Now on to the Founders Award. The Founders Award is presented each year at graduation to a member of the graduating class who best exemplifies the characteristics of scholarship, sportsmanship, and leadership. Please join me in welcoming Will Griswold, a member of GDS's class of 1981, to present this year's Founders Award.
Intelligent, determined, empathetic, and creative. This year's Founders Award winner is a person of high character and represents everything good about Greensboro Day School. Her academic record and leadership are exceptional, earning an A-plus average and nearly perfect SAT and ACT scores. But these attributes alone do not define her. One of her primary goals throughout high school and her personal life were to find a balance between her intellectual pursuits, friends, family, and athletics. This young woman has used her competitive spirit to excel in the classroom while leading her lacrosse team on the field, even overcoming a severe knee injury in the process. And in lighter moments, she can be found in the kitchen making delicious desserts for her family, friends. Balance. She also has a heart for community service, modeling annually in the Big Hair Ball, an extravagant fashion show, hosted annually by the Junior Guild, helping to raise hundreds of thousands of dollars in support of the family services. Scholarship, sportsmanship, and leadership are the essence of the Founders Award, and this year's recipient checks all the boxes. It's my pleasure to present this year's Founders Award to Franny Goodman.
Thank you, Will. Congratulations, Jack and Franny. Yesterday, during our closing faculty and staff luncheon, we recognized a special faculty member. Each year, GDS distributes and recognizes the J.P. Hendricks Excellence in Teaching Award. And yesterday, last year's winner, Tom Zott, presented this year's winner. So please join me in re-congratulating Pete Buxenbaum for this year's Hendricks Award. And now it's my privilege to present the Distinguished Alumni Award. It's a well-known fact that Greensboro Day School alumni go on to do extraordinary things after graduating, and you all will too. In recognition of the excellent work and service accomplished by our alumni, the Greensboro Day School Alumni Association established the Distinguished Alumni Award in 1991. This award is presented annually at graduation to an alumna or an alumnus who best exhibits at least one of the following qualities: extraordinary service to the city of Greensboro, the state of North Carolina, or the nation; extraordinary distinction in one's field of specialization; and extraordinary service to society and corresponding tangible benefits to fellow citizens. It is my pleasure to recognize this year's recipient, Dr. Stephanie Marshall Thompson of the class of 1998. Let's give her a round of applause. Before she comes up, I'd like to tell you a little bit about Dr. Thompson. Dr. Thompson is a reproductive endocrinologist and infertility specialist at the Institute for Reproductive Medicine and Science at St. Barnabas in New Livingston, New Jersey. She is an attending physician in the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology at St. Barnabas Medical Center. Dr. Thompson received her undergraduate degree in Spanish from Wake Forest University and her medical degree from University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill. She has, she's board certified, and she's completed her residency at New York University Medical Center, and she's completed her fellowship at Rutgers, New Jersey Medical School. Dr. Marshall is only one of five black female infertility specialists in the entire United States. Dr. Thompson has received many honors throughout her academic career and has actively contributed to the field of scientific research and literature. Dr. Thompson shares her expertise on the national stage as well as numerous news stations. This year, her documentary that aired received a Gracie Award, which is an award which recognized media created by, for, and about women who've made an inspirational contribution to the industry. Dr. Thompson, we congratulate you on your many outstanding achievements that have changed the lives of so many, and we are so proud to call you an alumna. It is my sincere pleasure to welcome today the 2022 Distinguished Alumni Award. Dr. Thompson, will you come on up?
Thank you so much, and thanks for the opportunity to say a few words this morning. I'm honored and overjoyed to receive the Distinguished Alumni Award for 2022. I just want to say thank you to my parents. That never stops, graduates. My sister, Whitney, from the class of 2004 at Greensboro Day School, and my husband, Sean, for helping me to achieve my goals. To the class of 2022, the education you received at Greensboro Day will undoubtedly prepare you for higher education and to succeed in life. But what I really want you to take from your education here are the critical thinking skills that you learned and apply them to making real change in America in light of all of our recent events. I remember deciding in the seventh grade to take Latin because I thought it would help me in medical school, but it also helped me to understand the mottos and foundation this country was built on. E pluribus unum, out of many, one. So go forward and use your skills, privilege, and knowledge to make this country better for everyone. Congratulations to all of you and best wishes.
Thank you, Dr. Thompson. It is now my pleasure to introduce this year's graduation speaker, Molly Levison. Molly is a graduate of GDS from the class of 1994. She lives in Washington, D.C. with her husband, Josh, and their three children, Henry, Lulu, and Livy. Molly is the founder of a strategic communications advisory firm who serves as a strategic advisor to influential leaders and businesses on issues involving media, policy, and the law. Over her two decades of practice, Molly has developed hundreds of comprehensive communication campaigns. She is also a leading architect of the effort to achieve pay equality for the United States Women's National Soccer Team, serving as an advisor to the team and the Players Association since its inception. PR News named Molly for one of the top women in PR in 2021 and called her a known problem solver. And they did this when they honored her as the 2017 Crisis Manager of the Year. We could have used you, Molly, a couple years ago. Law Dragon named her one of the top 100 legal strategists in the US in 2021. And we are very thrilled to welcome her back to GDS and on stage today as our speaker. Come on up, Molly.
Thank Thank you so much, Tracy, for that extremely kind introduction. And I have to say that as I sit here this morning, I am reminded once a Bengal, always a Bengal. Good morning, trustees, faculty, parents, families, alums, and the unbelievable class of 2022. I would also like to say good morning to members of the class of 1994 and my sister Sarah's class, the class of 1996, who are here. These people are very special to me because they are my classmates, my lifelong friends, the people who played on swings with me when I was 8 years old and who later sat next to me, brimming with excitement at this very event 28 years ago. I'm Molly. I'm a proud GDS alum, class of 1994. You heard a little bit about my strategic communications firm that I founded. I'm a leader of a team of expert advisors for influential leaders and brands. I'm a former journalist and television producer. I covered politics for a long time before I launched a business, and I still voraciously consume the news. And most importantly, I'm a mom of three kids, class of 26, 27, and 29. For the class of 2022, you may know that there is more than GDS pulling my class of 1994 together with yours. We all represent a full two generations of graduates. There are some of you in the class of 2022 whose parents were my and my sister's classmates. So it is a profound honor and very meaningful to me to be able to share this morning with you all, to take stock of all the promise that it holds, and to reflect on what we have learned, most especially what we have learned from each other. I met with a group of 22ers a couple months ago as I was preparing to give these remarks. I see many of you out there. You shared your stories with me, and I was able to learn a lot from you. We talked about what GDS means to you, how much you will miss all of your friends and your teachers and your families when you graduate. We talked about the fun events that you've had this year, your trips, what it was like to be together. And we also talked about the things that have been very hard for you. You told me about how your high school years have been defined by the challenges of COVID, how much lesser it feels when you have to be virtual. You told me about the numerous events that you missed and wished you had had, all of the moments that you were not able to share together. The masks, one-way walking, the frustrations you felt when you missed the trips, the dances, the parties, day-to-day existence of being together. What you would have had if you had been able to have all of those moments in real life. Class of 2022, you know a whole lot more than I did when I was sitting where you are. You know how sweet it is to spend time with your friends when you are finally reunited. You know this from the earliest days when you weren't back in school, but you would find time to be with your friends in a parking lot, just being able to see each other in real life. You know how much to treasure coming back to school, what it means to sit next to each other in class, how much more rewarding it is to learn from teachers who are standing at the front of a room rather than being on a screen. You know the joy of a full return to normal when you are finally able to take off your masks, take the mantle of your senior year back, and go off campus again for lunch. The old hard choices are so much easier for you now. There is no choice between being able to go out and spend time together rather than wasting time online. You have realized what it takes others countless years and many dumb mistakes to learn. You fully understand the limitations of what virtual is. You recognize that it's a superficial realm where you only see them when they're happy and that it is so much more on the surface. You want more for yourselves than virtual. You know all too well how much being virtual can make you feel like another rather than making you feel like you belong. And you have experienced firsthand how much being in real life can make you feel a part of something bigger than yourself, needed and loved by your friends, the people around you, and excited and engaged to be present. This is your superpower. Understanding the value of being in real life is a key to so much. Once you understand the essence of what it means to be in real life, You have the tools that you need to build anything, change anything, and lead anything. When it comes to building, changing, and leading, I have a short story to tell you about why your superpower can make all the difference. Last week, I don't know how many of you all saw this, but the U.S. Women's National Soccer Team, athletes like Alex Morgan, Megan Rapinoe, Becky Sauerbrunn, Kristen Press, Tobin Heath, Carly Lloyd, Kelly O'Hara, won a tremendous victory, achieving equal pay after almost five decades, 50 years, of fighting to be valued and paid equally to men. Last week, for the first time ever, a national federation, the U.S. Soccer Federation, announced that it will pay its men's team and its women's team equal amounts, including giving equal bonus amounts for winning the World Cup. I cannot tell you how difficult it was to achieve this outcome. The women players had to win hundreds more games than the men, including four World Cups and two Olympic golds, which the men did not win. The women had to demonstrate that more people watched their games and they brought in more revenue year after year after year before justice could be done. I also cannot properly put into words how much more of a fight there is on behalf of equality. This historic victory isn't just meaningful for the soccer players, but for people everywhere. It's also a victory that is very near and dear to my heart as I, along with a team of wonderful and very dedicated people, helped to make it happen. Now here's where I'm going to take you into the true behind the scenes. No one has ever really heard this part before. Strategizing that went into figuring out how we were going to win equal pay. We had taken every possible step we could for years, except for one. It was the one thing we had left to do to win, but the stakes couldn't have been higher. 5 years ago, we knew that our last resort was to file a lawsuit against the U.S. Soccer Federation, the employer for the players, the organization that decides how much they get paid. We knew the facts were on our side, but we also knew that the fight would be really hard. What if we lost? What if we took some of the highest profile celebrity athletes in the world, people like Alex Morgan and Megan Rapinoe, and filed a lawsuit to fight for equal pay, and we lost? Not only would that be devastating for the players and future women soccer players, but what would that mean for women everywhere, in workforces everywhere? The stakes were incredibly high. We began to strategize how we would launch the effort, how we would engage the world, how we would change minds, how would we persuade skeptics, how would we win over our adversaries, the allies we would need, the goals that we needed to reach. Our objectives meant we would need to create a tremendous platform out of very few resources. We had no budget, no marketing, no sponsors, no infrastructure, no institutions. We had, count them, fewer than 30 soccer players, a handful of advisors and lawyers, a lot of hope and a commitment to change, and a World Cup tournament in 3 months. When the players made the decision to proceed, it was very late at night on a Sunday in February 2019. Everyone had their job. The lawyers had to write the lawsuit, the players had to go train and win the World Cup, and we communicators needed to make sure that the entire world watching the World Cup would understand that beyond the incredible world-class soccer that was being played throughout the global tournament, equal pay was the real focus, the real conversation. At the 2019 World Cup, we had to make sure that it wasn't just a soccer game. Equal pay was really at stake. Now here's where your superpower comes in. This is a thing you learned because of COVID, when you missed out on chunks of high school together, when you experienced all the distance and isolation of being virtual. And it is the very same superpower that ultimately allowed us to win equal pay. When your words and actions only appeal to a few people, you make all the others feel like outsiders, like they don't belong. When you only speak to people who agree with you, you create deep and prohibitive divisions with those who disagree with you. In our equal pay effort, our top goal was to make equal pay everyone's mission, to make it a global goal. It was not just a women's and girls' fight, it is a fight for everyone. It is not a political fight for Republicans or Democrats, it is above and beyond politics. It is not just an athlete's fight, it could be a fight for other workplaces too. As Megan Rapinoe has wisely said for years, when we win, everyone wins. We wanted to build the broadest, most inclusive, most accessible, most empowering global movement we could possibly build. And starting with the World Cup in 2019, when millions of people in France rose up in the stadium after the US women won, and the first thing they chanted in unison was equal pay, we did that in real life. As everyone here knows, the US women's national team won the 2019 World Cup in France. During that time, we began shooting a film, a documentary of our equal pay story called LFG, which I will not tell you what it stands for. Instead of shutting them off, we would talk to anyone who disagreed with us. We sought out our skeptics and made our arguments directly to them. We sat down with people who had long questioned our effort, Major League Soccer owners, leaders in other leagues, leaders in businesses, sponsors. We didn't fight against them. We were patient and we listened to them. We heard their questions, answered them thoughtfully, and then we persuaded them to join us. We started to succeed at getting sponsors to listen. Big brands stood up in support of equal pay, and US soccer had to listen to them. We had many obstacles in our path. In 2020, with the onset of the global pandemic, we suffered serious setbacks in our legal effort. A judge ruled against our case in summary judgment. The players had to juggle training during COVID, the effects of the pandemic on their league. All the games stopped. Everyone had to stay home. The Olympic Games in Japan were canceled, and still we pushed on. We filed an appeal of the court's ruling against us to breathe life back into the legal effort. Our movie, LFG, premiered in a big glitzy premiere and then aired on CNN and HBO, reaching millions more people. We looked for every opportunity we could to find people who you would not expect to champion our fight. Allies who could help us appeal to those who traditionally would have disagreed with us. The men's national team wrote a strong and supportive legal brief on our behalf. So did others. Sponsors and big brands launched efforts to close the pay gap. Looking back, I've often thought about my time at GDS as one of the reasons why I can understand the value of in real life, and that is one of the reasons we won equal pay. I am not a soccer player. In fact, as my mother in the audience would tell you, I could very well be considered to be an actual detriment to any soccer field I might attempt to play on throughout the limited soccer career I had, which ended at the age of 10. However, I have several skills that help me lead our successful fight for equal pay, many of which I learned through my time at GDS from teachers like Mrs. Upton, Mrs. Windham, Dr. Gutzel, Mrs. Davis, Mrs. Fish, Coach Johnson, and others. One, I'm a pretty good writer, skills honed in AP English and History, and as editor of the GDS Press. Two, I'm a passionate advocate. Though I almost always lost student council elections to my friend Ross Vanderlinden, I learned in my years here that I had the power to change things by convincing other people to join with me to change them. Three, I learned that I can love and respect people who I might disagree with. A powerful lesson which could change the world if it was broadly applied. GDS is a place where I learn to listen, even when I might disagree. It's a place where other people listen to me, even when they disagreed. Where people have a range of very different views and perspectives, but understand that there are larger, more important values that bring them together. Virtual relegates us to the most simplistic and surface understanding of things. It forces the loudest voices to the forefront, even when they're not the smartest voices. In real life, that's different. In real life, sometimes the quietest people have the best ideas. I also think this is a community where if you see something you want to change, people join with you to change it. Where adults and teachers truly advocate for things that students believe in, even if it is as small as going off campus for lunch. When you take everything you've learned, even through some hard times these past years, you have a lot to take with you. You have a community that has embraced you if you want to fight for good. You value and love your friends. You truly know how much they mean to you. You've experienced firsthand what is lacking in just being virtual, and you deeply understand what is so meaningful about being in real life. Here are some of the pieces of advice you gave me to pass along for yourselves as you head off for the next part of your lives, as well as to those who come after you at GDS. It all goes by so fast. Live every opportunity. Play all the sports, do all the things. Take every opportunity to have fun. Manage your time, get off your phone, and get out of your room. Enjoy it. Really appreciate what a special place GDS is. Be your best. Don't live 3 or 4 years stressed out. Don't focus on every single quiz grade. You'll end up where you're supposed to. Help people who are confused or scared. You can help them participate. You can make any bad situation good. Take action and change it for yourself. Please take your superpower with you. When we win, everyone wins. When you create something or try to change something or lead something, figure out the most expansive, inclusive way to do it. Listen to people who disagree with you. Talk to them, find things you have in common, and embrace them. Remember how much better it feels to be together. Leave your rooms, spend time with other people. Notice if someone around you seems lonely. Reach out to them, make them belong. Sometimes there is no choice but to be virtual, to send a text or an email, to be on Zoom or WebEx, to Snap, Insta, or tweet. When you do it, try to be kind and try to find the quietest voices. Seek them out and listen to them too. And remember, and I say this on behalf of all the moms and dads out there, when you head out to college, go out there in the world to do amazing things. There is no channel or platform, no artificial reality or metaverse that can hold a candle to being in real life. Come home as much as you can from college. Thank you so much, and congratulations to you all.
Please join me in another round of applause for class of 1994, Molly Levinson. Seniors, it's now time for the awarding of your diploma. Come on up, Mr. Williams.
Thank you. Joining us on stage today is Mr. Chuck Keeley, board chair and GDS alumnus from the class of 81. I would also like to invite Mr. Kim Burrows, our most tenured faculty member in attendance today, to join us for the awarding of diplomas. Mr. Burrows. Mr. Keeley and Ms. Catlett, it is my pleasure to confirm for you this morning that each member of the class of 2022 who is sitting on stage with us today has met the requirements established by Greensboro Day School for graduation and so is qualified to receive his or her diploma.
Thank you, Mr. Williams. On behalf of the Greensboro Day School Board of Trustees, I am proud to congratulate the class of 2022. Acting under the delegation of powers by the Board of Trustees, I authorize you, Mr. Williams, to confer the diplomas. Seniors in the first row, please stand.
Elizabeth Brooks Adams. Greta Rose Anderson. Garland McLean Bell. Anna Catherine Brown. William Scott Cantliff. Lucius Jefferson Chapel. Graham Joseph Senior. Winston Elizabeth Simino. John David Civils III. Vernon Paul Collins Jr. John Coulter Cox. Xander Wheeler Craven. Benjamin Matthew Dalstead. Emily Gray Davis. Michele De Guglielmi. Michael P. Decker. Kyle Avery Feinstein. Zhaoxiang Aaron Fong. Gabriella Fernandez Bruff. Ryan McCain Fowler. Amir Yevrukin Gavatov. Armando J. Garcia Jr. Muzamani Shekwe Gausi. Francis McKee Goodman. Sarah Bergen Grapey. Nicholas Ryan Graves. Grace Caroline Griffin. Ketchuan Guan. Joshua James Hoffman. Brenna Sky Holden. Malia Nailani Hopkins. Amy Elizabeth Iupa. Charles Thomas Jennings. Connor McKinley Jones. Catherine Virginia Jones. Benjamin Andrew Jordan. Roland Dennis Ken Williams. Eliza Winfield Kirkpatrick. Oliver Pavio Krimer. Russell Dean Lee. Sarah Bradley McCorkle. Faith Boswell McDonald. McKieran Maeve McElroy. Carter Daniel McWhorter. Warren Blaine McWhorter. Daniel Moule. Anna Elizabeth Newsom. Jackson Connor Noble. Kylie Christine Patrick. Wesley David Pinfield. John Phillips. Sarah Lillian Piccarelli. Margaret Howell Pierce. Boone Hart Poole. Arjun Ramachandran. John Simeon Reich. John William Riley. Chase Knight Risden. Abigail Elizabeth Schneid. Georgia Alexander Severa. Braden Reeves Somerville. Chloe Margaret Stevens. Benjamin James Stewart. Natalie Brooke Strader. Richard Parker Stroud. Leia I. Swanson Perez. Alexander Joseph Turner. Louise Magdalena Regina Verhoeven. Riley Rebecca Wagner. Zoe Kexon Wynn. Kathleen Marie Whitener. Elizabeth Suzanne Wilcox. Henry Clark Wilcox. Xiao David Xiao. Kevin S. Hsu. Michael Robert Zanoni. Zhu Kaka. Zhu Mangia. Jeffrey Diezi Zigbo. And now it is my honor to begin a new tradition started by the seniors of this, the class of 2022. As I invite Ms. Catlett back to the podium, seniors, please don the caps which you will find beneath your chairs, placing your tassels on the right-hand side.
Looking good. All right. Now you may move your tassels to the left signifying your graduation, and would you please stand? I present to you our newest class of alumni, the alumni class of 2022. Standing, and we will sing the alma mater. Alumni, thank you for your impact and the legacy you will leave behind at GDS. Remember, once a Bengal,
always a Bengal.
All right, thank you. And now, friends, please join us in the alumni gym for a reception, and we'll see you there. Congratulations.